Okay, so welcome to the Pranayama session. And this session, we will keep it more of the informative session as well. You can pen down anything you want to in between. Mr. Judy. Sit in comfortable meditative posture. Roll the shoulders back and down. Center yourself physically, mentally. And we will start the session with three chants of Omkar. Inhale. Slowly blink your eyes, gently release. Namaste everyone. You can do the stretches or anything you want to do. I will start the session with a small introduction. You can also even focus on your normal breathing pattern. So what is pranayama? Why we are doing pranayama? What is the need? How it does work? Just the basic explanation. So first we'll start with the meaning of pranayama. Prana, which is the vital force. It's not only the air, it is subtle than the air. And it is existing in each and every body part, each and every cell, everywhere it is. There is no space left which is not having the prana. Because without this prana, there is no life. And if there is lack of prana, the region may start functioning improperly. The quality of that region will start to deprove, that will lead you to cause of diseases. So when we see that the disorders or maybe diseases are happening in the body, it's not only the physical aspect. They first happen in the pranic body and then you can see it physically. So everything, maybe even a single cough and cold, first the changes are happening in your pranic body and then slowly it will showing in the physical body. Ayama means to control, and control means we are trying to regulate our breath as we want to. The way we want to regulate it, we can do it, which also expands the efficiency of breathing in and breathing out. The breath control improves, cardiovascular system improves. So pranayama is the entire control of your breath or prana. Now the meaning of pranayama is clear. Why we are doing the pranayama? We also know that physical body is not the only part of our existence. We also have the pranic body where the entire pranic system flows. Now, as per the yogic approach and the Ayurveda, human system consists of five shets. Shets, you understand, layer. For example, you can see the tree from the top. Then below, you will see the soil. Below the soil, there is roots. That is how our body is also. So first, you can see your physical gross body. Then within the physical gross body, there is pranic body, pranamaya kosh. Then inside the more subtle layer of the body is mind body, manomaya kosh, and then the other two. There are a total of five sheds. Physical gross body, annamaya, pranic body, pranamaya, mind body, manomaya, vijnanamaya. It's more of the intellect and the higher than your mind. And lastly, Anandamaya, which is the complete happy state, the state of yoga, you can say. But we'll skip the last two. That's more of the spiritual approach and the deeper approach of the practice. We are only talking about the second one, pranic. Our body has five pranas.
What is the fifth one?
Anandamaya. fourth one is Vijnanamaya and Anandamaya. Okay, so five pranas are there in the body. Simply, you can understand it as the regions. For example, which energy is governing the chest region? That is your, the name of prana itself is prana. Okay, which regulates all the functioning of heart and lungs, your thoracic region, your inhalation that you take in. Everything is governed by this prana. Second is apana. The name of second prana is apana, which is below the navel, lower abdominal region and the pelvic region. It is governing more of your lower abdominal organs, your kidneys, your reproductive system, your excretions. Even your exhalation is also governed by the apana prana. Then samana. It is in the abdomen, in between the navel and the diaphragm. Only the abdominal organs like your stomach, liver, pancreas, these intestines, these are getting regulated by the samana prana. And above your chest, there is udana prana, which governs the throat, the head, all the sensory organs like ears, your nose, the sensory perception that we have, the brain. These all are governed by the udana prana. Now there is one prana which is everywhere in the body, vyana. It's, you can relate it to as your circulatory system. Your circulatory system is everywhere, right? Head to toes. So that's vyana prana is everywhere in the body. It is kind of helping all the other pranas to work properly. Okay, so these are five pranas in the body, and the pranayama works majorly in the pranic body. Okay, now there are also sub pranas. Like you understand, we do sneeze, cough, feel hunger, blink the eyes, feel yawning. These are also controlled by some of the pranas. These are sub pranas, hiccups. It is not something which is very commonly come. There is something, these sub pranas are controlling all of them. Your hunger, your belching, your hiccups, blinking your eyes, yawning. And you must have also noticed that after the body dies, some of the body parts still work. Our body is not dead just at once. It takes some time. That is one prana which is called as Dhananjay, which works in after the death. Like after the death, there is one prana which is not allowing the body to die completely at a go. It's just decay slowly, slowly. That is called Dhananjay. So this is your pranic body and the pranayama. Now, I hope it is understood. If your saman prana is not fine, then you will start having digestive problems. If your prana is not working fine, then you will start having some cardiovascular issues. Similarly, if anywhere in the body the prana gets imbalanced, the deterioration happens in the physical functioning of the body. Then it leads to disorders. This is how the general physiology works. So when you're having a disease, it's not like an injury that I got hit, it's a cut, blood is coming out, it's a pain. This is the direct, but when the disease happens, it starts happening slowly. It will not happen in one go. So that is why it's very important to keep our pranic body healthy and breathe efficiently. It is also, a lot of research has also happened that if you breathe deeply and fully all the time, your mind is also in a calmer state and your body will also keep functioning well. Even the quality and quantity of your life also improves when you're practicing the right type of breathing. Okay, there are very few examples, there are so many examples, I'll just give you two. Observe the dog. the dog is breathing very fast through the mouth, very rapidly. The lifespan of the dog is short, 12 to 14 years, that's it. Same way, if you observe the turtle, it breathes so slowly and it can live for maybe 500 to 700 years also. So I'm not saying that we will expand the lifespan to 100 years, 500 years, 400 years. It used to happen in the ancient time when the yogis were doing it. But now we are just talking about the general health concern. So to bring it back, it's very important to bring the awareness to your pranic system. Shall we start the practice? Let us sit in comfortable posture. You can change your asana if you need to. I hope you were following the normal breathing throughout. We'll start with the cleansing breath, Kapalabhati. The cleansing breath is the first practice we should do. Okay? During the night, it should not be done because it also prevents the sleep. It awakens the mind, bring it very actively. So during the night, after the sunset, the stimulative practices should be avoided for the longer time. If you're learning, that's okay. But if you're regularly doing it, then it should not be done. Let's begin. Kapalabhati, right palm on the belly. We all know how to practice Kapalabhati. Let us continue. And if you feel dizzy or heaviness in the head, put a less force in the exhalation. Keep it soft. Stop whenever you need to. Contraindications are hypertension, hernia, heart conditions, ulcer also, because in the ulcer your pitta is high. Menstruation, pregnancies, in all these conditions, Kapalabhati should be avoided. One more minute.
Ananda.
exhale. Gently release and see if there is natural hold of the breath happening, retention. Hold the breath for as long as possible. Gently soft inhalation, soft exhalation. Now, three very important steps for the pranayama: urak, rejak, kumbhak. Urak, full breath in; rejak, full breath out; kumbhak, holding the breath. Internal kumbhak, antar kumbhak; external kumbhak, bahya kumbhak. Yogic breathing. Inhale completely from the belly to your chest to your collars. Exhale from the collars to your chest to your belly. Inhale completely and fully. Exhale completely. But it should not be forceful. You should not be straining the lungs. Intensity might increase with the practice. As you are breathing more, the deeper inhalation and exhalation is improving breath by breath, and it is getting softer. Use your diaphragm for the better inhalation. Last four. Release gently. Soft inhale, soft exhale. Now Nadi Shodhana is very important to practice before the other deep pranayamas. So Nadi Shodhana for next 4 to 5 minutes. Curl the first two fingers. Inhale left. Exhale right. Inhale right. Exhale left. Second round, inhale left. Exhale right. Inhale right. Exhale left. Continue alternate nostril breathing. Nadis are the energy channels in the pranic body through which the prana flows, and the Nadi Shodhana helps to purify the energy channels. Shuddhi means purification. We should be avoiding Nadi Shodhana in case of flu, fever and cold. Also in case of sinusitis, if your nostril is blocked, then also it's hard to do the Nadi Shodhana. Otherwise, it can be practiced in all the conditions. Minutes of Nadi Shodhana. Following the Purak and Rechaka in every round from now, complete breath in, complete breath out in Nadi Shodhana. You can use the chair, Judy, if you find it difficult to sit. Need to go? Alright. Complete the last round. And gently release the Nadi Shodhan Pranayama. Feel free to choose your own practice, last two practices of the pranayama. Okay, you can take your call and later we will move into Q&A part, question and answer. So finish your two practices by yourself, maybe 10 rounds of both. Each practice.
Which practice?
Anyone. Any last two. Your choice. You have learned a lot of practices in the regular pranayama.
Brahmari.
Brahmari, Udgit, Ujjayi, Chandrabhedan. Any of them you can pick. Even you can pick Suryabhedi also.
It should be tranquilizing or anything.
Any, keep the last practice as tranquilizing.
So I'm doing thoracic breathing. Correct me if I'm wrong.
Thoracic or Ujjayi?
Ujjayi, thoracic, same, right? No? Ujjayi.
Ujjayi, you can do with the full yogic breath.
No, the one.
That's Ujjayi.
The inhaling, Ujjayi. Thinking.
If you're doing with inhalation, exhale from the left nostril without the rubbing. If you're doing with exhalation, don't use the hand.
I'm doing both inhale and exhale. And
then don't use the hand. Don't use the hand. Simple nostril. Last 2 minutes.
sar fadiru chamaudi افکان ده به رخ سور جان موی سیاهی بچینم سر راهی با امید نگاهی بچینم سر راهی با امید نگاهی خدایا تو گواهی چه نغز است و چه خوب است و چه زیباست خدایا چه گرمیم از اینش چه خورشید چه پنهان و چه پیداست خدایا
Slowly release. A short silence. Gently join the palms to the heart center. Namaskara Mudra. One Omkara and three Shanti. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Rub the palms, generate the heat. Palms all over your face, your eyes. Open your eyes with blinks. Slowly release.